When the camera's rolling, your heart pounds. It's thrilling to me.
How excited? You got to be thrilled that you get to play in front of the Bills Mafia. I mean, you haven't really experienced them as much because you're new to the team, but that's a big deal up there. I mean, are you ready to smash some tables this week? What's going on?
Listen, man, it's a huge deal. These guys, man, listen, they are the rowdiest fan base, they would love to say, in the world, but definitely in the league, man. These guys, they set up each and every games because they really, truly adore their football team. Their club, if you go to any, like, big schools or whatever the case may be, you know, that town is like a college town atmosphere. This is like that, but in an NFL level.
Yeah.
You know, and it just, a sea of red and blue and white, like, these guys actually, like, come out in droves for the Buffalo Bills. And it's a generational thing. And this is one of, you know, a couple teams in the league that actually have fans like this. But it was great to see them, you know, come out into the stadium last week. 6,700 guys. I mean, filled out the place. It was scattered around, so it sounded way more than the number. But you can hear them. They was loud and they was proud.
You essentially throw Phillip Rivers a retirement party, and Josh Allen goes off last week. He has 324 yards. He rushes for a touchdown, throws a couple of touchdowns. What separates Josh Allen as a leader, and how much have you seen him grow this year?
Man, what separates him is just his canny ability to battle. To not be rattled, like, to win, no matter what. Like, he wants to win the game himself. But he also got to a point where he's now so much more poised. Mm-hmm. You know, he's not rattled by much anymore. Like, before, he probably would make a mistake here and there, but he has learned from that. He has gained knowledge.
You're going into a huge game, obviously a divisional game on Saturday, and the Ravens are coming off of a big win on Super Wild Card weekend. Lamar Jackson gets the monkey off his back. He can win playoff games now. He's got a ton of confidence. They're riding high. How do you even go about, you know, stopping or slowing down Lamar Jackson? How do you contain a guy like that with that much talent?
Well, he can do everything, but where he affects everyone now is his mobility and him eluding defenders and getting outside of pocket. Last year, he was able to do it with his arm. This year, he's showing his repertoire of being able to be a run force on the ground. Guys have over 1,000 yards rushing as a quarterback, so... You know, you look at that, and he can throw the ball, man. He's a dual threat, and he can, you know, break a big one in any given moment if you're not contained. And yeah. So for us, we just have to be, you know, mind at all times where he's at, and pretty much be on our keys like none other, because he's a threat every time he touches a football. So we got to be wary of that and understand, you know, where he can hurt us. And try to do our job and the best of our abilities to try to contain him.
No doubt. And then you got to be aware of all the firepower he's got. Dez Bryant looking a little better, finally comes back, makes his way back in the league. Mark Andrews, Snead, they got Hollywood Brown. You know, I feel like you guys, if anybody, from going against your own team with Diggs and Beasley and John Brown, I mean, it's kind of iron sharpens iron over there. Has that helped you prepare for a wide receiver group that's, you know, potentially equally as talented?
Well, when you look at it, you know, their guys is 15, 89, and 27. Like, that's their bread and butter. They bail cows. And we know what that looks like. We know who they are. And what makes everything go is number eight. Number eight.
Yep.
End of the day, like, that is our focus. We're not too much concerned about too much more or anything else. You know, we got our keys, we got our, you know, our targets, and we just got to go out there and execute the game plan, man. You know, it's nothing more than that. I don't try to make it bigger than what it really is. These guys are formidable opponents, and we just got to take them as if we would take any other team and going through our prep throughout the week.